Welcome students, in this module we will discuss about the diseases and its types. So first of all, it is necessary to know what is a disease. Disease is any harmful deviation from the normal structural or functional state of an organism, generally associated with certain signs and symptoms and differing in nature from physical injury. A diseased organism commonly exhibits signs or symptoms indicative of its abnormal state. Thus, the normal condition of an organism must be understood in order to recognize the hallmarks of disease. Nevertheless, a sharp demarcation between disease and health is not always apparent. The study of diseases is called pathology. It involves the determination of the cause of the disease, which is called as the etiology, the understanding of mechanism of its development, pathogenesis, the structural changes associated with the disease process, morphological changes, and the functional consequences of those changes. Correctly identifying the cause of a disease is necessary to identify the proper course of treatment. Humans, other animals, and plants are all susceptible to diseases of some sort. However, that which disrupts the normal functioning of one type of organism may have no effect on the other types of organisms. Major distinctions. The normal state of an organism represents a condition of delicate physiological balance or homeostasis. In terms of chemical, physical, and functional processes maintained by a complex of mechanisms that are not fully understood. In a fundamental sense, therefore, diseases represent the consequences of a breakdown of this homeostasis. In some instances, the affected mechanisms are clearly indicated, but in most of the cases, a complex of mechanism is disturbed, initially or sequentially. And precise definition of the pathogenesis of the ensuing disease is elusive. Death in human and other mammals, for example, often results directly from heart or lung failure. But the preceding sequences of events may be highly complex, involving disturbances of other organ systems and derangement of other control mechanisms. Diseases can be classified into different categories, but on the basis of their occurrence, broadly they can be classified into two types: congenital diseases and acquired diseases. What are congenital diseases? These are the anatomical or physiological abnormalities present from the birth. They may be caused by a single gene mutation like alkaptonuria, phenylketonuria, albinism, sickle cell anemia, hemophilia, and color blindness. Congenital diseases can be caused by chromosomal aberrations like Down syndromes, Klinefelter syndromes, and Turner syndrome. They may be caused by some environmental factors like cleft palate, hair lip, etc. Unlike the genes and chromosomes induced congenital defects, environmentally caused abnormalities are not transmitted to the children. Acquired disease. The diseases developed from after birth are called as the acquired diseases. They are further divided into two types: communicable and non-communicable diseases. The diseases which can be spread it from one person to another person or which are caused by viruses, bacteria, fungi or any other microorganism are generally referred as infectious diseases. While non-infectious diseases are remain confined to the person who develops them and do not spread to others. Non-communicable diseases further classified into four types: degenerative diseases, deficiency diseases, allergies, and cancer. Degenerative diseases are also called as the organic diseases. These diseases are due to malfunctioning of some of important organs, that is heart diseases, epilepsy, etc. Heart diseases results from the abnormal working of some part of this vital organ. Epilepsy may result from abnormal pressure on region of the brain. Some common examples of degenerative diseases are Alzheimer's, motor neuron, Huntington's disease, spinal muscular atrophy, progressive supranuclear palsy, etc. Deficiency diseases are caused by the deficiency of certain nutrients like minerals, protein, carbohydrate, fat, and vitamins. For example, due to the deficiency of vitamin A, night blindness is caused. Beriberi is caused by the deficiency of vitamin B1, scurvy by the deficiency of vitamin C, rickets by the deficiency of vitamin D, bone and tooth decay by the deficiency of calcium, goiter by the deficiency of iodine, and anemia by the deficiency of iron. Allergies. Allergy is an immune system response to a foreign substance that's not typically harmful to our body. These foreign substances are called allergens. They can include certain food particles, pollen grains, or pet animals. There are different kinds of allergens. For example, food materials, ecological factors, household chemical substances, frost or sun, a particular type of medication, pet animals, insect bites, dust particles, pollen grains, and some poisonous plants. Cancer. It is caused by the uncontrolled and abnormal growth of body tissue. When any cell, which is normal, start proliferating itself and the rate of cell division is disturbed, it multiply and proliferate rapidly, which give rise to a tumor. This tumor is often considered as the cancer. Thank you very much, students. More about the cancer and diseases we will discuss in the next video. Thanks for watching.